Hi, this is Kevin Bacon again, and I just thought I'd shout this one out. This is the quickest and simplest way to put together a rocket stove, albeit not very durable. This is 4-inch stovepipe, a 4-inch stovepipe elbow, and the other piece of the 4-inch stovepipe. Put the two together, and basically you've got the insides already built. Now, this isn't going to last forever. It's not going to burn near as long as my exhaust pipe, but for all intents and purposes, this thing will work. It'll get you started. You find out if you're interested or not. If you're really not interested in it, you haven't spent much money. I think there's less than $10 here, and it's all done deal. 4-inch, 4-inch, 4-inch. They make 5-inch. They make 6-inch if you want to get a lot bigger, but 4-inch is really a powerful little stove. You might want to make it a little taller than that. We measure the height from the bottom here to the top. Remember that this one was 14 or 16 inches tall. The average stove that I make is about a foot tall. So, there you go. Very simple. Okay, on the second issue, I was asked about how we would go about making a space heater out of the rocket stove. So I'm going to fire this thing up and I'm going to show you how that's done. Alright, I stole this idea from Harold and Billy Plum. Basically, when they wanted to heat their kitchen a little bit, they'd take a flower pot and set it upside down on the burner and turn the gas on the stove a little bit. The flower pot gets hot and it radiates the heat out and away. Now, that's not a very big flower pot for the size of Bertha here, because it's putting out a tremendous amount of exhaust and it's not a big enough pot to handle it. But it's getting pretty hot. You see the match ignites out the top hole, so if there's that much heat coming out the top, pretty soon this flower pot is going to get pretty hot, and I can feel the heat clear back here. It's warming it up. There's a bigger flower pot might allow for better exhaust. We wouldn't have quite as much smoke, but there's one answer right there. Without going into building a fancy big steel superstructure to go on top of here, you got a flower pot. Flower pots obviously were baked at a tremendously high temperature to make them in the first place, so they can handle the heat fairly well. I wouldn't recommend putting a wet one on there. It'll probably pop and fall all apart. But, there you go. Radiant heater. Cost me about $2 for that flower pot. The bigger ones are a little more expensive. You might even have one laying around. That's it. Simple solution to a question that was asked. And I'll send another video out shortly. Thank you very much.